Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. In a previous video, we made a two-stage rocket out of two balloons in a plastic cup. And it works like this. This orange balloon is holding the white balloon in place. When I let go of the orange balloon, the air goes out. And when the orange balloon deflates, it releases the white balloon. A two-stage rocket. Remember, a force is a push or pull. The air inside this balloon was pushing against the table, it was pushing against the air around, and it was even pushing against the pull of gravity. Well, today we're going to try and make another two-stage rocket with balloons, but instead of a cup, we're going to be using rubber bands and a binder clip. We're going to be using the binder clip to pinch the end of the balloon to hold in the air, and we found that just by running two pieces of electrical tape on the inside of our binder clip, allows that clip to hold the air inside the balloon a lot better. So the first thing I need to do after I have my balloon blown up and the binder clip securely on the back is to put a rubber band around my balloon. And I might even want to go with two because this rubber band is going to be holding another balloon closed right next to this balloon I have blown up. So I have two rubber bands here pinched around this one balloon. Now I need to blow up my second balloon, sometimes stretching it makes it easier to inflate. Here we go. And I have my two balloons for my two-stage rocket. Now I have to be able to take the end of this green balloon and slip it under my rubber bands. If my rubber bands are tight enough, it'll keep the air of the second balloon inside the balloon. I'm almost ready to launch. Now this next part can get tricky. You might even need a friend to help you out. I'm gonna take a little bit of a larger rubber band and I need to slide the rubber band over my green balloon and my orange balloon so that it actually lines up to look more like a rocket. It is definitely easiest if you have two people trying to work on this and having one person hold the balloons, another person able to put the rubber band over top of the balloons. You'll notice I had to slide this rubber band further down because this rubber band kept popping off. So it is a process, it's science. So I'm ready to launch and I'm gonna hold the orange balloon so you can watch when I remove the binder clip, the air will come out, this orange balloon will get smaller, and then eventually it will release the green balloon and that's the second stage of our rocket. Are you ready for launch? So I'm actually going to take the binder clip off first because I want you to watch right here at the green balloon and the orange balloon where they meet. So as I let the air out, watch what happens to the green balloon. Here we go. It gets smaller. I let it go. The green balloon took off. So we pull the camera way back so you can get a better look of our two-stage rocket in action. Let's launch this thing and see how she flies. One, two, three. The green one released. We had a successful two-stage launch. Just interesting to point out, the rubber band stayed on the first stage of my rocket. So as this one got smaller, it eventually released the second part of my rocket, the green balloon. Now we can do a whole lot of other really neat things with our rocket. Designing your own is where science really gets creative and fun. What if I used longer balloons? Could I make round balloons work? What about these? These actually look like they have bubbles and ridges in them. It'd be a lot of fun, but take a look at my design idea. I wanted to see what would happen if instead of one booster, my rocket actually had two boosters that could go off, power this, and then the green balloon part of my rocket could finally launch into space. I wonder how long I could get this to stay in the air. I wonder how far I could get this to go. I could measure all kinds of things and document my science and really make myself into a scientist at work. If you want some other design challenge ideas, or if you want to learn more about forces, check out our playlist. Science is so cool, especially when it involves taking off, because who knows where it will take us. 3, 2, 1. We have a successful liftoff.